Today my topic of discussion is that how can we improve the philosophy of democracy? The philosophy of democracy is a great gift of Western European thinkers to the mankind after a long struggle against monarchies. The philosophy of democracy was developed, actualized, and Britain was lucky to start it. The idea of democracy is that ruled people have right to elect their rulers, and only then the public interest can be safeguarded. To actualize the idea of democracy, electorates, electoral processing, voting rights were given to the people, and voting rights give people to elect their rulers, their government, and finally the government remains accountable to the voters for a fixed tenure, and that is all about democratic philosophy. To ensure that government remains people-oriented, government remains public-oriented, public welfare-oriented, there is no better ideology and philosophy than the democracy, and voting is the most important instrument to realize the idea of democracy. Of course, liberal thinkers of the Western world, American world, all have contributed a lot in reaching the idea of democracy and further strengthening the concept of democracy. It means a government where debate, discussions in the parliament take place, voting take place, and the government decides on issues, whatever it takes necessary. So there are various layers of the democratic process. First thing is that a government is elected by the people, because people participate on the basis of universal franchise, and then the candidates fight and put up their agenda, and finally people vote, and that candidate who gets majority of vote is selected, and then on that basis a ruling party is formed, and then finally a parliament, legislature is there to frame laws, and laws again are voted by the majority of members. So it's a very fine arrangement, it's a very fine framework to ensure the accountability of the government. But the process of democracy or the philosophy of democracy needs further to be enriched by the advent of internet, because what we find in the democratic process that normally people due to their various issues do not remain located at particular area or for some other reasons also. So how to bring all people to vote for their government is a major challenge before all election commissions, because normally we find that 60%, 70% people vote in the government, and then 30% remain out of the loop, and their opinion is important. So many people think that what my one vote will matter, this, that. So of course there is a voter awareness program done by election commissions of different countries, but that has a limited success ratio. So what next? How to make the ease of voting? I think the key to this answer lies in the ease of voting. When we have today our internet accessibility from any part of the world, we can do banking. From any part of the world, we can communicate. And there is an encrypted and safe communication process. So why can't those people who want to vote, if they are not located in their geographical boundaries and they are outside for certain works or for the ease of voting, why can't they vote through their mobile banking linked software where it is enabled on the basis of OTPs? I mean, there are certain people, mostly the upper strata of society, are people with different kind of business and other obligations, medical obligations, so many things. So I think this will enhance the participation of people in the democratic process. Because if I am given a linkage to my voting process through some mobile app, which is further linked to establish that I get an OTP before I quote that OTP. So this will make a lot of in the process of voting and further enhance the participation of the people. I mean, there can be several platforms, several software architectures can be designed. An app can be designed where a voter can find his name, you know, where it exists, and then on the basis of his Aadhaar card or election card number, he's there and one OTP is enabled. And there can be further safeguards. I mean, that person can be, you know, to quote his bank account, etc. So at least 2-3 OTPs can be mixed to make it foolproof so that nobody hacks it or influences in between. And then the after 2-3 safeguards, a person can be allowed to vote even from remote areas through his mobile or through his computer whatsoever. I think internetization of democratic process is the need of hour. Many people remain in abroad, many people remain in hospitals, many people remain in various engagements. So if they all are allowed to have this access to the voting process by using their mobiles or applications or internet accessibility wherever they are comfortable, this will add a lot of value in the system of voting process. And I am sure that through this process, the participation of people will increase in the electoral proceedings and will finally actualize the democratic spirit more and more. I think app-based voting, what are our hitches? There normally is that if there is app-based voting, there then maybe people who may be, you know, influenced or who may be threatened or who may be like that. So there can be, there may be some safeguards. So somebody can take my money by my ATM. I think my ATM, I am keeping my ATM, and if I somebody want to rob me, he can take it. It will not be possible for anybody to fuzz like that, to terrorize a person to vote because he is planning to vote through mobile app. Yes, of course, those who want to vote in the polling station, they must be allowed to vote. And then those who want to vote by the mobile apps, they should be allowed to vote. And it will be it should be safeguarded through several layers of OTP. I mean, not only one OTP through Aadhaar, another OTP should go to his banking number. And he can also give the similar, at least another telephone number who can be, you know, used as a secondary OTP. So all these three, if they mix and match, and a person's location is also identified on the basis of app, and I think that that person should be allowed to vote. So the pre-apprehension that this may disturb the voting behavior of the people, or they may be influenced, or they may be, you know, scared, I think it has very little basis. If that is to be seen, then every process can be influenced. So we should not try to base our arguments on the basis of some possible exceptions. What my point is that we should increase maximum participation of the people in the voting process, so that truly a government is elected by all of its people. And I am sure that if we encourage the internet-based or app-based voting, our voting percentage can go to 90-95%. Believe the kind of political landscape what will emerge out of that. And government will be more confident because it will enjoy the mandate of all the people living in the territory or in the state. I think that a time has come. India should take a lead. Being an IT efficient country, and our another thing I would suggest is that why can't there are a lot of allegations and there are a lot of apprehensions with regard to EVM. Just as I'm not an IT expert, but I can always suggest that why can't we have cloud collection of the data simultaneously in the machine as well as on the internet, so that in case machine is physically damaged due to any reason, the cloud data can be reliable and it should be encrypted, and it can be, you know, stored in real time, and it can be another another matching kind of parameter to know the sanctity of the machines and all that. I mean, election commission should think that there can be a simultaneously cloud-based voting data is maintained there, and that can be a dual storage of the data. One data is in the hard form in the machine, EVM, the other is on the cloud and on in real-time basis. And the election results can be announced on the basis of collating both the data, and it will give further credibility to the system. So one cloud storage of data in real time while people are voting, and the second would be that facilitation of internet-based, app-based voting with several layers of OTP or other security features. If these two things are done, I think that it will internetization, it will increase the internetization of democracy, which is the need of our. Internet has affected our entire life very much, and we cannot insulate democracy. And I think it is a logical expectation that democracy should now use the opportunity made available by the internet. And internet can change the behavior of voters. I think that internet accessibility and ease of voting will actually increase the participation, and there will be a great realization of the democratic philosophy if it is done. Thank you very much. This was the idea which was coming to my mind, and I thought that I should share in discussion. Thank you very much. God bless democracy. God bless.